instead of naming The Undertaker or Kane the WWF champion after they double-pinned Austin at Breakdown, McMahon got infuriated with the demonic brothers.
Well, they didn't protect him.
And he's going to make them wrestle. The Undertaker and Kane going to wrestle in 3 weeks at our next pay-per-view, Judgment Day. And Austin's going to be the referee. On that night, we'll determine the WWF champion.
Wow. But first, Mr. McMahon, he did one other little deed tonight. He forced Kane Kane and The Undertaker into this handicap tag match. But I don't think this has worked out like Mr. McMahon planned it.
This was perhaps punishment for The Undertaker and Kane. Yes, I will agree with that. It also somewhat punishing for The Rock, Shamrock, and Mankind to have to be partners after beating the hell out of each other in a solid steel cage just last night at Breakdown in a triple threat match.
Watch this, JR.
Kane up on top. Watch this agility.
No!
He's a big red missile that found its mark. 325 pounds. There's a cover. No, he didn't get it. Near fall situation there. And there's another tag. That WWF title match just last night. And by the way, the encore of Breakdown will be tomorrow night on pay-per-view. That match last night at Breakdown was the title was the most controversial match for a title that I think I've ever seen in that kind of, in a triple threat environment.
Right, and it was still up in the air tonight. Who was the champion? Was it The Undertaker? Was it Kane? And now we still don't know.
And Austin proved once again that he is indeed the toughest SOB in the WWF to merely won't be able to walk out of the ring last night.
Wow.
Oh, what a shot. Mankind caught The Undertaker coming in. Mankind matches up very well with The Undertaker. They've been in some wars. They've been buried alive. Oh, heck of a shot right there by the Phenom, knocking down Mankind.
And another
thing, cover. But
just thinking about last night, JR, can you believe, do you remember when Mankind dove Jimmy Superfast snook-alike off the top of that cage?
Must have been 15, maybe 20 feet there.
Oh! Yeah, but nobody was home when he got to the bottom.
Folks, if you missed Breakdown, you got to set that VCR tomorrow night and watch it on pay-per-view. The Rock wants a piece of The Undertaker. The Rock is
on
Mankind again. My God. He may have just busted his kneecaps and broken his shins right there. Folks, we have taken our last commercial break.
We're going to be here for the duration.
Absolutely.
Watch it. Watch
Kane
it.
In front of us here.
Watch it.
Big evil son of a gun with a steel chair, and that's bad. That's bad for whomever it's intended for.
What's The Rock doing now?
Rock and Shamrock up on the apron.
Uh-oh, look out, Mankind!
What a shot right to the side of Mankind's head. Good God Almighty, he's knocked out. Poor old Mick Foley in his Mankind attire. He ain't gonna last much longer.
He gets those brain cells scrambled 4 or 5 times a night. I don't see how there's any left now.
This could be it right here. Well, he had enough wits about left in that brain. Those brains weren't too scrambled. He got the foot on the bottom rope. Certainly don't see any bald 45-year-olds playing the air guitar here. As Kane, the youngster, the younger brother of The Undertaker, 7 feet tall, 325 pounds. I think he's still growing.
Oh.
And he could be the next WWF champion. We'll know that in 3 weeks. Oh, good move by Mankind. Now he needs to make a tag.
Oh, look at that.
Kane setting right up just like his brother, The Undertaker.
Well, what would his brother, The Undertaker, do if Kane was declared or if Kane wins that match? I mean, that's got to be on The Undertaker's mind right now. How can they coexist? That's what's surprising to me.
We remember the battles that The Undertaker and Kane have had.
Yeah.
And some of them have been real epics from the standpoint of the Inferno match.
Oh.
The match they had at WrestleMania. Mankind has just been isolated. Very sound, smart strategy. Mankind being double team, but at breakdown, it was both Mel downstairs. And a double arm DDT. That may be it. Maybe that's the move Mankind was looking for.
He got him.
The Rock wants, he wants in, and so does Shamrock.
The Rock goes screaming, come on, you jabroni, tag out.
Shamrock, will he take Mankind's tag? I'm not sure. To make sure, Mankind tags in the Rock. The Rock fired up on The Undertaker. The Rock all up in The Undertaker's face. The Rock looking to lay the smack down. There's a DDT. Oh, a thunderous DDT. That could be all.
No.
And a near fall. Oh, this jumps to The Rock. Only 2 years in the business.
Look at that.
Oh, here we go. Yes.
You're kidding me.
It's the people's elbow. The people's elbow on the dead man. Boom! Right in the heart. Does he have a heart? And Kane interrupted the count. The Rock going for the cover. Here comes Shamrock. Shamrock trying to head off Kane. The Rock and The Undertaker are the legal men here. Undertaker fired back up. There's a shot in the face of Mankind.
This is chaos. Look at this.
Shamrock and Kane up and over. And The Rock now taking The Undertaker to the corner. The Rock, the youngest man to ever be the Intercontinental Champion. He wants to be the WWF Champion. Makes the tag to Mankind. He's got a score to settle here.
Right, I think this is more like what McMahon had in mind. Finally, The Rock, Shamrock, and Mankind are operating as a unit. Finally, it is 3-on-2, just like McMahon wanted it to be.
Undertaker and Kane, are they going to be taken to the woodshed by these three men? Is that the pittance for Mr. McMahon? Oh, Shamrock looking for the ankle lock. Shamrock looking for the ankle lock. And Kane in. Oh, Kane came in quickly. There's a tag made right there. Here comes The Rock again. Shamrock nails Kane. The Rock and The Undertaker, toe to toe. Rock set for the ride. The Undertaker, and we're just about out of time here, I'll tell you that. Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute, the Rock bottom, Rock bottom, Rock bottom, yes!
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking?
Big Taker! Has been high.